their faith reinforced every so often by supposed sightings. The assassination of John Lennon is somewhat harder to deny. There were too many witnesses. But now we're asked to believe that the spirit of John Lennon lives on through a New York businessman. Martin King reports.
Four. Everybody's talking, no one says a word.
I want to say this to everyone who's listening, that it's possible to have peace all around the planet.
It sounds like John Lennon.
It was my objective when I was in my body and you called me John Lennon. I'm not actually him anymore. I'm a lot more than that.
But it looks suspiciously like a 42-year-old American called Bill Tenuto.
Almost anybody can be a channeler, just as almost anyone can learn to play something on a piano.
Bill Tenuto is a New York business lecturer who first tried his hand at channeling 10 years ago when he lived in, how did you guess, California.
This is something that involves an ability to open up, to open the mind and allow the conscious energy of another being to enter in.
Bill says he's been opening his mind to John Lennon and a host of others ever since he got his channeling L plates.
When I began to channel John Lennon, I discovered a side of him that I had not known about before, a very tormented side to him. He seemed to feel cheated out of love. But what also came through a lot were his wit, his sense of humor, sometimes sarcasm, his caring about people.
John Lennon had never felt safe on the streets of New York City, but Yoko Ono convinced him that he was just being paranoid. Then, on a cold night in December 1980, a lone gunman appeared from the darkness here outside their apartment building and pumped four shots into the man who'd devoted his life to the cause of peace.
Within minutes of the shooting, mourners began to gather. All night, they kept coming to the regal old apartment building on the west side.
What's the sensation when you're channeling someone like John Lennon?
I feel literally lighter, as if every molecule, every atom in my body is opening up and being flooded with light. That's the sensation. It's an incredible sensation. I'm starting to experience some of that now as I talk, which is wonderful. Would you, wouldn't mind, I think I'm about ready to channel. Would this be an appropriate time for that?
Certainly.
What have we got here?
This is an interview, John.
What's your name, please?
My name is Martin King. I'm a reporter from Australia.
Don't know that we've had the pleasure.
Well, we haven't had the pleasure, but how do you do?
All right, I think.
We're in New York, John, the city where you were shot.
Well, you would have to remind me of that, wouldn't you?
Sorry.
It's quite all right.
John, what happened after you died, after you were shot?
I want to say this to anybody who cares to listen to me, to anybody who would like to know about death. Death is perfectly safe. I want you to know that. There's nothing dangerous about dying. It's perfectly safe. There's nothing to be frightened of.
Do you have a message for your fans?
Crap on that, you know? I mean, my fans, I have a message for anybody who wants to listen. The message is we can have peace if you want it. I might be no longer in my body, but it doesn't mean I'm not thinking and I'm not feeling. I could still make things happen. Just as I did when I was called John Lennon.
Nobody told me there'd be days like these. Nobody told me there'd be days like these.
Now, it may be that Bill is the world's greatest ham, but to be fair, we should point out he isn't making any money out of it. He doesn't charge for appearances, and in a city like New York, that's considered much more crazy than talking with a fake Liverpool accent.
Strange day to see.
Got to go. Goodbye. Has been nice. It's been nice chatting with you, but I got to go now. Yeah. This is very emotional. That was powerful for me.
But a lot of people may say you're just a good actor.
If that's acting, I think it's the highest form of acting that's possible. I certainly experienced a spirit with me, a spirit who says his name is John Lennon, and I experienced whatever he was thinking, whatever he was feeling, and as faithfully as possible, I vocalized that. Nobody told me that.